Oh man, remember at the end of September when the Pittsburgh Steelers is 1-2-1 and everybody was saying, well, they're at the bottom of the division. They're tied with the Cleveland Browns. They're never going to win the AFC North. Well, the bye week just passed and for some apparent reason, there's some animals that's behind us. There's a Raven. There's also a Bengal. A plumber was on his way to work. He dropped off a couple of toilets and lo and behold, the Cleveland Browns started rolling out. Turns out we're back in possession of the number one spot in the AFC North. Everybody who was out there chatting it up in comment sections talking about me in the Pittsburgh Steelers, they don't got it no more. Big Ben's washed up. They need Le'Veon Bell. Their defense is atrocious. Well, a couple of those can possibly be right or wrong, whatever the case may have been, but we're back in possession of the number one spot. Nonetheless, we coming out the bye week. Now, granted, Mike Tomlin's record coming out of bye weeks is 7-4. He always has the, you know, they make their adjustments, what has to be done. But we're playing against the Cleveland Browns. Let's just touch on a couple of things first. First things first, all right? We got to be able to take care of the football. Week one, 5 turnovers resulted in a tie. Granted, you had a couple of weather defects that happened. It was raining terribly. Guys couldn't keep their balance. You had 3 interceptions for Big Ben, 2 different fumbles, a couple of bad calls from referees on both ends of the game. But I expect us to go out there and play effective football. Granted, we're not playing against Tyrod Taylor. We're playing against Baker Mayfield. But I'll say this about the Cleveland defense. They are one of the better teams in taking the football away. I believe their plus minus is plus 10. They have a 10-plus turnover differential. They're able to take the ball away, but they're struggling offensively because they can't punch it into the end zone. That's where we have to be able to capitalize, because offensively, we've been able to, you know, play effectively these past couple of weeks. James Conner been able to run the football. Ben has been able to throw the football. Antonio Brown has been getting into the end zone. Juju Smith simply cannot be covered. Vance McDonald, he's doing what the hell he's doing. You got Jesse James, he's always open for a couple of receptions. We got to keep that train rolling. Moreover, we got to stay healthy. Defensively, we got some guys coming back. You got Morgan Burnett. I believe he's going to be healthy, being able to play this game. We got a couple of other people who's going to be back in the lineup playing effective Pittsburgh Steelers football, but we got to be able to take care of the football. Cannot turn it over. Now, defensively, we have seen Baker Mayfield be a turnover machine. By machine, I'm not talking about super turnovers where you're looking at 4 or 5 a game, but he's turning over the football. A couple of interceptions here. Possible fumble here. Offensive line can't seem to block here and there from time to time, but we got to be able to keep this man on the run. We cannot let him get comfortable in the pocket. We have one of the better front sevens in the league when it comes to blitzing the quarterback. We got to be able to do that. Now, Carlos Hyde and Zeke is no longer in the backfield. So that number one running back is either going to be Duke Johnson or it's going to be Nick Chubb. I'm pretty sure Chubb is going to be getting the majority of the carries. I have no confidence in this man being able to run against our defense. However, he is still a capable running back. You saw what he did on 3 carries to the Oakland Raiders. We cannot allow that to happen. We got to be able to contain this man and hold him under 50 yards. They will not be able to run the football. They're going to become a one-dimensional team. When it comes to receivers, like I said in my pregame analysis, we've got to be able to contain Jarvis Landry. Joe Hayden, that is your responsibility. You did a very good job, masterful job, stupendous job, pulchritudinous job on Julio Jones. I need you to go and replicate that exact same thing. Might I add, you also did the AJ Green as well. We need that coming in to this game. This 3 straight games, you're going against a very elite receiver. I need you to go out there and play effective football for the rest of the guys who are there. The others on the Cleveland receiving core, also their tight end Njoku. We can't allow this man to activate the vibranium that he got from Wakanda. Njoku and Njobu, well, guess what? Black Panther's fake, just like your goddamn powers. It's not going down. We got to be able to stop these guys from getting open. Might I add, Cleveland, 3 and out machine. They're constantly getting drives and good field position, and then they cannot capitalize. Like I said, we got to be able to get that done. TJ Watt, you always happen to have phenomenal games against the Browns. I need that again. I need that again. Your very first game in the NFL, you had, what, 3 sacks against the Cleveland Browns? Guess what? Remember those 3 sacks you had against Atlanta? I'm going to need you to get another 3. Your brother played phenomenal on Thursday night. Keep the family tradition going, and you play marvelous on Sunday afternoon. We're going to need to see another big-time TJ Watt performance. In the secondary, I'm going to need some interceptions. I'm going to need to take the football away, because what we're doing defensively, we're stopping people. We're just not taking the football away. Special teams, I'm going to need a couple of block punts. I might just need a punt return touchdown. I might just need a kick return touchdown. We got to be able to get points on every aspect of the game. Offensively, I'm not too worried. I have confidence in our offense as long as we just take care of the football, regardless of what the weather defects are, whether it's raining, whether it's snowing, whether it's a goddamn hailstorm, whether it's a damn monsoon, earthquake on the field. Well, if an earthquake happened, obviously they'd stop the game. It's not like you're going to be running, trying to get to the end zone. It's not going to be looking like the Dark Knight when they're playing in Heinz Field. You got Heinz Ward running back a kick return Why is he even running back a kick return? It came out 2008. This man was well into his career. He was not on special teams, but nonetheless, we don't need the goddamn ground, the pavement, the gridiron collapsing while we're trying to get into the end zone. People don't need to die in order for us to score points. All right, but nonetheless, we got to go out there, play great football, three aspects of the game, and continue to hold our spot at the top of the AFC North. The Ravens, struggling. The Bengals, struggling. Back-to-back losses. The Browns, they coming in. Back-to-back losses. We got to be able to capitalize on their failures. I'm not sitting here watching other people's games and saying I'm rooting for you guys to lose, but if you guys keep losing, I'm not complaining. But we got to take care of what we can take care of. All right, so we're going to go get this big-time AFC North W because we need to get a one-up in our AFC North standings. We can't have that 1-1. We need to be able to go, oh, I should say 1-1-1. We got to break the trend of ones. Let's get that 2-1-1, and we're gonna move on to week 9 with a victory so we can go get our rematch against the Baltimore Ravens. Everybody get your hand up in here because we're going into Heinz Field. We're back in Steelers country against the Cleveland Browns, and we're leaving with a damn W. Steelers on 3, win on 6. 1, 2, 3 Steelers, 4, 5, 6, win. And everybody else in the AFC North, I just want you guys to understand, because when the Pittsburgh, we run the AFC North. There's a reason why we had that hoodie when we won the North with the extension of Antonio Brown. I just want to leave you with a quote from Ric Flair, because whether you like it or don't like it, learn to love it, because the Pittsburgh Steelers is the best thing going today.